Hey, Erica. Exciting day.
Hey, Ash. It is indeed.
So today we released a Granite 3.3 speech model.
We did. Our first speech model that excels at automatic speech recognition.
Okay. So I can take just speech or audio and then put that into a AI model and do something with it?
Yeah. So think about Apple Siri or Amazon Alexa. Those are speech-to-text models. But we've open-sourced the Granite 3.3 speech model, so anyone can use it for any speech-to-text tasks.
Oh, wow. Okay. I can think of lots of things that I could use this for, like audio transcription. What are we going to show everyone that we can do with it?
Yeah, that's exactly what we did. We transcribed audio from one of IBM's podcasts, Mixture of Experts.
Okay.
And then from there, we used a separate model, also out today, the Granite 3.3 Instruct model, to then take the transcript and summarize it.
Oh, wow. So you've basically taken a podcast and you're converting it into text and then taking that text and then summarizing it so that I can get a quick summary of the podcast?
Exactly.
Oh, wow. That would be so time saving. There's so many podcasts out there these days. I would love to be able to do that with a few of them myself.
Yeah.
I can't wait to hear more. Are we going to walk through how to do it?
Yep. Happy to show you.
Okay.
So the tutorial is currently out on IBM.com, but it's also available on GitHub. And you can either download the notebook, you can run it on your local machine or on a Google Colab notebook. In our case, we used the watsonx.ai platform notebook to run this notebook here.
Okay.
So the first thing that we have to do, of course, is to download some packages and libraries and import them. So we're going to download torchaudio, install soundfile, and the transformers library. And we also have a couple of packages to download audio from YouTube.
Okay, cool. So we're basically going to be able to take a podcast from YouTube and use that as input for our speech-to-text model.
Yep.
Okay.
Any video from YouTube.
Any video. Oh, yep. Wow. That's actually pretty useful.
Yeah. So we set a variable called URL, in this case for our specific Mixture of Experts episode here. And then we can download the audio file by using the .streams method. And it outputs an M4A file.
So I could basically go into that URL and change that for any URL for a YouTube video, and I can go and fetch just the audio from that video for me to use.
Exactly.
Perfect.
So from that M4A file, we need to convert it to a .wav file for the model to be able to consume.
Okay.
So we do that in this code snippet here, and then we can use torchaudio to load that file. And we get a waveform and sample rate from torchaudio.
Okay.
So it outputs a stereo waveform, but we need to convert it to mono so that the model can consume it.
Okay, that seems like a really important step to remember. So we're going to convert the stereo audio into mono so that we can have something more efficient to pass to the model?
Exactly.
Okay.
Yep. We also need to change the sample rate. So the previous sample rate was very high, so we just need to change it to 16 kilohertz.
Okay.
So we do that with also with torchaudio. And then finally, before we instantiate the model, we're going to take the 37-minute audio and split it into smaller chunks. And this will be really easy for the model to then inference from, as opposed to having one long file. It's going to have 30-second little intervals to be able to inference from.
Okay, I mean, that makes total sense. I guess that we want to not have like a really, really long inference time running against the model. And I guess that probably leaves opportunity for people to put sort of like try failure logic in there so that if you do have the transcription sort of like fail for any reason, they don't have to start from scratch and they can just do the chunks that they're missing.
Exactly. Yeah, it gives you an opportunity to be able to track the progress mm-hmm. of individual chunks, and also in case you lose internet connection or anything happens, you you don't have to go through the entire transcript again.
Okay, that makes total sense.
Yeah. So here we instantiate the speech model and use some transformers libraries to also take in the processor as well as a tokenizer. We also ran it in, like I mentioned, the watsonx.ai platform notebook, and we just need to do a slight adapter config.json file change in this code here. And then finally here we can instantiate speech granite. We feed it a chat so it knows to transcribe the audio. This is part of the prompt that we're going to feed it.
Okay.
And then from there, we have this for loop to go through each chunk and generate the transcript. And like you mentioned, someone can add some try except code in here if there are any issues as well to make it a little bit more robust.
Okay, perfect.
And once we get that whole list of mini transcripts, we're going to join all of those into one large transcript.
Okay, so then this is where we get the complete audio transcription of that that podcast.
Yep.
Okay.
And we're calling it full transcript.
Perfect.
And then finally, we're going to use the Granite instruct model, also out today, the 3.38b instruct. We'll instantiate it similar to what we did with the speech model. And we're going to give it a prompt to just summarize the transcript that we gave it. And let me show you what the output looks like. So here's the summary. It starts with the 50th episode of Mixture of Experts, et cetera. It gives a pretty concise summary. And I think it looks pretty good. What do you think?
Yeah, that is actually great. And it gives me the opportunity to be able to know what was in a podcast before I have to listen to the whole thing. This saved me so much time, and I'm really, really glad that you've shown me where I can change the URLs. I can't wait to get this running myself. Thank you for sharing this, Erica. So the link to our code on GitHub and the link to our web tutorial is going to be in the video description for other folks to be able to use as well.
Yep, and it's all ready to download and use on whichever platform you prefer.
Amazing. Thank you, Erica.
Yeah, thank you, Ash.